Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot. I decided to do a daily vibe for the 4th because it just seems logical. I just did a new moon reading, but I need to do a daily vibe because I just do. I just feel the need, so that's what I'm going to do. So we're just going to see what comes up for the 4th. Somebody's not happy. Somebody may have overindulged and they're not happy now. There's lack of abundance here, lack of wish fulfillment. Now, this guy has obviously went overboard, so now there's a price to pay. Queen of Wands. This is a very attractive individual. This is attraction, vibrant, determined, proud, passionate. So we have some sort of, ooh, Two of Cups. Somebody may have tried to control their feelings, tried to control an outcome. Two of Wands reversed. They may have been delaying. Oops. Eight of Cups. Somebody has walked away. There's been a fear of change. There's been indecisiveness. There's been indecisiveness. And I think somebody, the Eight of Cups, somebody's walked away. Leaving the emotional disappointment behind because there's no wish fulfillment here. So somebody is walking away from something that... Goodness of me. Wow. A lot of reversals here. A lot of reversals. So there's an absence of success. There's an absence of success. There's an absence of togetherness. There's an absence of, you know, coming together with a soulmate because of, oh, well, this guy has a big ego, the Nine of Cups. That's an ego card. It really is. Nine of Cups in the tarot is an ego card. Somebody let their ego get in the way, which has caused somebody to walk away. Five of Wands reversed. That is... it's like there's been some conflict, there's been some tension, but there's an opportunity to overcome this conflict if somebody could find their ability to find confidence, find courage, I mean, find their willpower to basically put in effort. It looks like somebody needs to find their confidence to put in effort to work together in a partnership. Somebody is probably walking away from a soulmate connection because of power struggles. Okay, we got some power struggles here. And it feels like, I mean, this Knight of Cups, there's no follow through. There's no follow through in the love arena. The Knight of Cups reversed. There's an absence of a relationship growing because of the need to control. There's ego. We definitely have ego here. The lack of respect. There's lack of respect. There's lack of compromise. We got somebody here that is clinging to control. And it's causing a relationship to basically no growth. It's causing no growth in a partnership. The ego is causing no growth in a partnership. And it could be falling apart. The partnership could be falling apart because of it. There's a lot of fear of the unknown with the Two of Wands reversed. There's fear of commitment. There's fear of, you know, allowing, you know, things to happen as they should. Somebody is really clinging to control when they should be just going with the flow. They should have confidence and courage to just allow. What is meant to be will be. It feels like we have somebody that here that is really putting their guard up. They're putting their defenses up when they should be just allowing. Patience is needed here with the Five of Wands reversed. Patience is needed. And somebody is probably losing patience. They're losing patience because they're wanting this happiness. They're wanting a commitment. They're wanting togetherness. They're wanting a relationship. And because it's not coming as they would like, there's no wish fulfillment. Somebody's walking away. Somebody's walking away because it's like there's no reciprocation here. Because there's so many, there's the ego. This is ego, this is ego. It's like the ego is so big. And there's anger and there's chaos. So I think that there's some somebody here that is fearful of getting into a commitment because of their ego, because of their pride. Maybe they got to prove themselves to everybody. Somebody has lost their focus and their concentration. The Emperor reverse. It's like somebody has lost their way. They've lost their way because of their inability to compromise, their inability to put in effort into a partnership. So it feels like the love, you know, the love is not growing. The relationship isn't growing. So it feels as though somebody is allowing, or they're are keeping themselves in an unhappy situation when they have the ability to let go of the need to control and let love in. I mean, there's an opportunity for love here with the Two of Cups. There's an opportunity for a loving union, but it's not growing. It's not going in the right direction. Two people are not seeing eye to eye because of control issues. Okay, there's control issues, there's power struggles here. There's lack of respect. Okay, somebody, there's the Three of Pentacles reversed. There's lack of respect, there's lack of togetherness. Let's get some more cards. We have a natural leader here who she can be impulsive. She wants it now and she needs to be patient. Be patient. So we have one person here that needs to have some patience. You know, she may be losing patience and she needs to have patience. I think that she may be pushing. Maybe she's pushing for something. She's pushing for love. This is an offer of love. So this is love. This is a welcome offer of love. This could even be an apology. It could be. Somebody may be offering love or offering an apology. Moving in your direction or moving in a new direction. Mastering their emotions. Taking the reins. Deciding that they are going to move forward. After they probably made a poor decision. That Nine of Cups reversed. Somebody made a poor decision which caused somebody to walk away. But there's a strong attraction here. This is deciding to take the lead, take the reins. I'm going to take control. I'm going to move forward. I'm going to find the discipline and the courage to master my emotions and we have somebody that is overwhelmed with pain. This is overwhelmed with pain. Three of Swords. They've been suffering. Somebody has been suffering. To the point where they can barely move. it's hard to see what's right in front of them. There's some confusion here. There's confusion because there's too much. This is too much. They may have too many responsibilities. They may be carrying too much. They may be weighed down by... too many things, too many responsibilities. We have somebody here that is really, really dealing with a lot of pain. They're dealing with heartache. And maybe that's why they're not putting in effort. That's why they're not communicating. The Three of Pentacles is a card of communication. It's reversed. It's like there's acute communication shut down because of heartache, because of pain, because of overwhelming circumstances. We have somebody here that is, you know, they're at that crossroads and they have an opportunity to go down a new path, but they're fearful. They're fearful of change, you know. But the Chariot is deciding to move. It's deciding to move on. It's deciding to face the pain. You see, the Chariot is facing the Three of Swords, deciding to face this burden, to deciding to face these responsibilities, deciding to move forward. Somebody is deciding to really make a move, seriously, quickly. I think there's probably a sudden, and this would be sudden as well, there's a sudden decision to basically go, because this is a vehicle, the Chariot is a vehicle, and this is moving very fast in another direction. So I think we have somebody here that has made a poor decision that has caused somebody to walk away, and now it's like they may realize that this is love. I mean, the Page of Cups, this is love. This is a welcome message of love. This is an offer of love. It could be an apology, it could be anything, but we have this other person here that, you know, has a lot of courage and has a lot of confidence, and this person, she has high self-esteem and high self-confidence, and she knows her worth, and she's probably standing strong in her power. And it looks as though somebody is receiving an offer of love because of their you know, she's a very noble queen. She is very noble. She's very generous. Anyhow, this is replacing that fear with faith. Somebody is ready to take charge. Really, seriously. Right now, it's like they're being divinely guided to get a move on. Get moving. This is move very quickly. Move forward very quickly and deal with this pain. Deal with this heartache. I think we have somebody here that has hurt another person. This is heartache. This is suffering. You know, and now they have to deal with it. They have to deal with this burden that has been caused by their lack of compromise, their lack of communication, their lack of respect. It's like this Knight of Cups reversed. This is a relationship that is going south because somebody has been basically too busy. They've been too busy and too burdened by everything else that they've let the love. They've sacrificed the partnership. They've sacrificed the love for everything else. And it's caused a lot of heartache. It's caused a lot of pain for another person. Anyway, I feel as though we have somebody here that is deciding that, you know, they're going to replace their fear. It's time to take the driver's seat. It's time to move quickly in a new direction. And I think we do have somebody moving very, very quickly. They're moving, traveling to a new destination. It's like they're literally traveling. It's like they're getting in their vehicle and they're heading towards, I mean, this is heartache. Three of Swords, that is heartache. That's grief. That's suffering. That's pain. It's rejection. It's a painful separation. It's a loss, okay? So I feel as though they're heading towards something that they may have rejected in the past, or they may have hurt in the past. You know, maybe it's weighed them down to the point where they gotta go deal with it. They gotta go deal with it because it's eating them alive. It's too heavy for them to carry. They gotta go heal this situation. Somebody may have been overly critical or misjudged a situation. And the only way, and they need to heal it. They do need to heal it. The Temperance reversed. Somebody overreacted. Somebody did overreact, and they've caused an imbalance in a partnership, and the only way to heal it is to literally take action and go. Go. So I think we have somebody that is making a decision to go. I gotta go. I gotta go heal this situation because it's only gonna keep it stay upside down. It's only going to remain unbalanced unless I fight for this partnership. So I feel like we have somebody that is basically deciding that I have to go. This is go. Sorry. There's been difficulty in communication. Big time. It's like there's some been some extremes here with the Temperance reverse. Things have been extremely up and down here. It's like one minute everything is good, the next minute everything is bad. You know, up and down and up and down and up and down. It's because somebody has been overly critical of the small things. It's like there's no need to sweat the small things. There's been a lack of patience too, okay? There's been a lack of patience. Somebody has been wanting to basically, you know, not let go of their need to control. And they've been trying to, it's almost like an impulsive energy as well. I know I'm going all over the place, but somebody has been wanting things to move too quickly. And I think we have this other person who's been fighting it all the way, trying to keep things under control. And this person has went overboard trying to remain in control. I mean, this Emperor reversed has really tried to prove a point. You know, I'm the boss. I'm the boss. And, you know, it takes two. It takes two in a partnership. There are no bosses in a partnership. So there aren't. There aren't. And that's where the struggle lies. I mean, here we have a partnership. There's two people here, not one. And here we have this Emperor who has probably, you know, criticized and misjudged the situation because of that mentality, you know, it's my way or the highway. That my way or the highway has caused somebody to walk away because it takes two. It takes two to build a relationship, for a relationship to grow. So anyway, I feel like we have somebody here that has been reluctant to compromise, and they have been reluctant to reciprocate, and it's because of their ego wanting to control a situation, and now they're overwhelmed with pain and heartache because of their need to control. You know what I'm trying to say? It takes two. It takes two to build a relationship, not one. So anyway, I feel like we have somebody that is deciding to take the reins. They're ready to head in the right direction to probably, I mean, it looks like they may want to heal this situation. And the only way they can do it is to go and maybe apologize or offer love. So the Page of Cups is a welcome message of love coming in. But it looks like this is traveling, so somebody could actually be arriving, okay? A message is coming. It may be actually arriving at your door because this is a vehicle. Somebody hasn't been listening to their intuition. they've been experiencing a loss of self because of their need to control. You can't, some things aren't in your control. What is meant to be is meant to be, and fighting it is only going to bring more chaos. It's only going to bring more burdens. It's only going to weigh you down even more. I really feel like we have somebody here that has been trying to control the script, okay? The high priestess holds the script, okay? And it's like, you know, whatever is part of the script, it's part of the script. You can't control what's part of the script. So, you know, I think that we have somebody that is deciding to move in a new direction, to deal with the pain that they have caused or deal with the pain within themselves. You know, it's time to complete this cycle. It's time for this union to come together. There's been a delay in it coming together because of criticism, because of misjudgment, because of pettiness. There's been some pettiness. There's been some drama. And somebody has walked away. Somebody has. The Eight of Cups. Somebody has walked away because they know their worth. You know, we have a very proud individual here who knows that they deserve love. We have a hard worker. This is a hard worker, somebody who puts in a lot of effort. And this person as well does fine on their own. They know that they can do fine on their own. They're very self-sufficient. They take care of business. This is the independent person who you know, has it all and does the hard work to bring abundance to their life. They really, you know, can handle life on their own. So I think we have a person here that is walking away from a partnership because another person couldn't reciprocate. It's like there's greed, there's ego, there's pride in the way. Somebody was greedy. Somebody was letting their ego and their pride get in the way. So this person has decided, you know what? I deserve love. I'll love myself and I'll take care of myself and I'll be self-sufficient and I'll be grateful for the experience and the experiences to come. And, you know, I'm abundant with myself. I can take care of myself. So I think we have somebody here that is walking away from a greedy individual who doesn't really have anything to offer. They're not offering it. They're keeping their love to themselves. It's like they want it all for themselves. Like, seriously, we have somebody here who is very self-centered, unfortunately. We have somebody here that is self-centered, that is losing an opportunity for love because of their inability to face change. Anyway, I feel we have somebody here that is deciding to go their own way because they were dealing with an individual who wouldn't take action. And it's like now somebody is taking action. Somebody is moving forward. It's like somebody is deciding to move forward. After dealing with some serious heartache. This Three of Swords is serious heartache, heart pain. So yeah, I feel like somebody is moving in the right direction towards love. This is the Two of Cups, towards love. After fighting it. Seriously, fighting it. It's like they can't fight it anymore. It's too much. It is. It's too much. What is this? Two of Cups. Five. Having a hard time tonight. Five. I'm having a really hard time talking tonight. I don't know why. Did I say Five of Cups? I think I did. Five of Swords. This is somebody, again, this is another ego card. This is somebody who wants to win at all costs, and it makes complete sense with this Nine of Cups reversed and this Emperor reversed. We got somebody here who has a point to prove at all times, and it's causing somebody to walk away. You want to win? You have to win? I will leave. So I feel like we have somebody here that is letting go of a partnership because whoever they're dealing with refuses to compromise. Refuses to work together as a team. It takes two to build a relationship, not one. So I feel like we have somebody that is deciding to take the reins, to take the lead, and go their own way because they don't want to stay in this heartache anymore. I think a decision is being made to take the high road. Somebody's definitely leaving with the Eight of Cups. They're leaving. They're leaving a situation that has not led them to wish fulfillment because of lack of reciprocation, lack of, you know, wanting to control. Somebody has wanted to control a situation to the point where, you know, it doesn't work that way. It takes two. It takes two to build a relationship, not one. Somebody's not been listening. They haven't been following the script. They haven't. And therefore, you know, they're not going to come together with the partnership that they were probably meant to be with because there's no... You know, there's pride and ego in the way. So yes, ego is big in this reading. Big. Ego, ego, ego. We got somebody in this partnership that, you know, I think both people are. There's definitely some power struggles. There's power struggles over, you know, who's gonna, winning and losing. It's not about winning and losing. It's about working together. Anyway, whatever. Navigating the stars. Follow your bliss. Trust your gut. And somebody hasn't been. Somebody has not been trusting their gut. Trust your gut. Have faith that a higher power is directing your life. I told you. Somebody hasn't been following the script, but whatever. Believe. Allow your life decisions to be dictated by what opens your heart and by what brings you joy. Relax. Be patient. Follow your bliss. Your life is divinely guided. And I can see that it is, but... whatever. All is going according to a wonderful plan for your life. Be confident that all is well. And this is the confidence that it was telling you about. We have one person that is confident that, you know, this is meant to be, but the other person is clinging to the control, clinging to the need to control what is meant to be. But anyway, all is going according to a wonderful plan, the script, for your life. Be confident that all is well. Sometimes you can't see the road ahead, but when you become still, you can feel the right way to go. It's like navigating by the stars. You might not be able to see every detail of the path of your life, but when you trust the light of the stars, your silent spirit guardians, and the joy of your guiding North Star to navigate in the darkness in the morning light, you find yourself at the right place at the right time. So somebody, you know, may receive some sort of epiphany or something, I don't know, that it's time to go after my bliss, it's time to move forward, it's time to trust, it's time to believe, it's time to listen. There is a relationship that is not coming together because of somebody's need to win. You need to let go of that mentality of winning. It takes two to build a successful relationship, not one. Somebody is deciding, I'd rather be alone. I would rather be alone than be belittled. This is belittled for both of these cards. Somebody has been belittled. They have been disrespected. So I feel like a decision is being made to move forward. They have been divinely guided to just go. However that resonates with you. Good luck.